afternoon and welcome to the Countdown Studio, the happiest days of your life. When school days are often referred to as the happiest days of your life, well, not if you were a youngster in Tom Brown's school days. Of course, Flashman, the bully, the school bully, was written up as pushing a small kid up to a fire until he was sort of burnt. But it was 30 years ago, when I had long since left school, that corporal punishment in schools was banned. Now, were my school days the happiest? Yeah, we sort of got institutionalised, actually. But punishment? Daily basis, Rachel. Daily basis. The method of punishment, and we were fine about it, really, was something called a pandybat, which was a whalebone covered in leather, spatula-shaped thing called a pandybat. It's amazing, really. And it was completely normal. Every school in the 50s and 60s had something similar. Some were canes, some were pandybats, some were ferulae. No problem. What about punishment at your school?
I remember when I was about four, my first kindergarten, we had these duffel coats, and if you were naughty, they used to do the duffel coats up, and it was so horrible. You actually couldn't breathe. I was getting stage fright when I was doing Strictly, so I had CBT, cognitive behavioural therapy. They give you a bit of a hypnotism and they tell you to go back to the first time where you had this like choking feeling around your neck. And it took me back to this memory that I hadn't thought of for 20-odd years of not being able to breathe in your duffel coat. I've dealt with the demons. I'm all right now.
Well done.
Moving on.
All right. Let's move on now to our contestants today. We've got Sarah Caperold down from Stirling, where she's a consulting engineer. Two good wins under her belt, vying for third today. Welcome back. Welcome back, Sarah.
Thanks.
And you're joined today by Noel McIlvenny, a maths teacher from Belfast, whose favourite musicians are Prince and Michael Jackson. And there's a little bit of a story attached to these two.
Well, for my 20th birthday, I was bought tickets to go see Prince down in Dublin. But unfortunately, the concert was cancelled. And it was announced on my birthday that it was cancelled.
Oh, bad luck.
That was unfortunate.
Yeah.
For my 21st birthday then, the next year, I was bought tickets to go see Michael Jackson.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, he died before I could go and see him, so...
A bit radical, isn't it?
I didn't have much luck when it came to
Indeed.
Concerts.
Extraordinary. Big round of applause then for the disappointed Noel McIlvenny and Sarah Caperold. And over in the corner, Susie, of course, and joined once again, his second appearance here in the countdown ring. And talking of corporal punishment earlier, you wouldn't want to get the wrong side of our wonderful, our ex-world champion, Barry McGuigan. Welcome, Barry. Now then, Sarah, we turn to you for a letters game. First one.
Hi, Rachel.
Hi, Sarah.
Could I start with a consonant, please?
Thank you. Start today with M.
And another.
T.
And a vowel, please.
U.
And another.
E.
And a consonant.
N.
And a vowel.
A.
A consonant.
S.
And a vowel.
E.
And a consonant, please.
And lastly, L.
And here's the countdown clock. Yes, Sarah.
An 8.
An 8. No.
Just a 7.
And your 7?
Amulets.
Amulets, Sarah.
Amulets.
Very good.
In the corner?
We got amulets. Minus to 7. We haven't got any more, have we?
No, quite a few 7s. Mantles, that sort of thing. But amulets was our best as well.
Well done, yeah. Excellent stuff. And no. Letters game for you.
Hi, Rachel.
Hi, Noel.
Could I have a consonant, please?
Thank you. Start with X.
And another.
S.
And another.
P.
Could I have a vowel?
I.
And another.
U.
And another.
I.
Consonant, please.
S.
And a vowel.
E.
And a consonant, please.
And the last one, D.
Stand by. Yes, no.
Seven.
A seven, Sarah?
I'll try a seven as well.
No.
Upsides.
Upsides and?
Pussied.
No. Not there, I'm afraid. Not there as a verb. Sorry.
What can we have, I wonder? Barry?
I've got the same as Noel, upsides.
OK. That's it, Susie?
That's it, yep. Meaning, especially in horse racing, alongside or on a level with.
Thank you. 1 point in it. Noel on seven. Sarah on eight. Sarah. Your numbers game.
Could I have one large, five small, please?
You can indeed. Thank you, Sarah. One from the top, five a little, and they are 7, 6, 10, 9, 3, and the large one, 75. And the target, 173.
173. Sarah?
172.
172, no.
173, not written down.
Okay, no.
75 times 3 is 225.
Yep.
9 plus 10 plus 6 plus 7.
9 plus 10 plus 6, 25 plus 7, 32.
And take it away. It's wrong.
Yes, it is. It's 193, I'm afraid.
Not wrong.
So, Sarah, 172.
I did 7 plus 3 is 10.
Yep.
Times the other 10.
100.
Plus the 75.
175.
And then 9 minus 6 is 3, and take it away.
Yes, for one away, 172.
There we go. And Rachel, 173.
Yes, one way you could have said 3 times 10 is 30, divided by 6 is 5, add to 9 for 14, times that by 7 for 98, another 75.
Well done. That's it, 173. That's the way we do it. So 15 plays 7 as we turn to our first tea time teaser, which is I eat large. And the clue, I eat a large portion of delicious ice cream here. I eat a large portion of delicious ice cream here. Welcome back. I left with the clue, I eat a large portion of delicious ice cream here. Where? Why? At the Gelateria. Gelateria? Gelateria?
Gelateria.
Thank you. All right. 15 plays 7, and it's Noel's letters game now. Noel.
Could I have a consonant, please?
Thank you, Noel. R.
And another.
Q.
And another.
T.
Vowel.
A.
And another.
E.
And another.
A.
Consonant, please.
D.
And a vowel.
O.
And a consonant, please.
And lastly, N.
Stand by. Yes, no.
Just a 6.
Sarah?
7.
And a 7, no.
Ranted?
No.
Donator?
Donator?
It is donator rather than which is really unlucky, Sarah. I'm sorry. Yeah, bad luck. It has to be the OR at the end.
Bad luck. What can we have, I wonder? Barry and Susie?
Donate.
That's it.
That was it.
All right. Six. Thank you. So 15, please. 13, only 2 points in it. And we turn to Sarah. Yes, Sarah.
Can I have a consonant, please, Rachel?
Thank you, Sarah. S.
And another?
B.
And another consonant?
L.
And a vowel?
U.
And another?
O.
And another?
I.
A consonant?
R.
And another consonant?
T.
And finish with a vowel, please.
And finish with A.
Stand by. Sarah?
Seven.
Yes.
And a seven as well.
Two sevens. Sarah?
Rituals.
And Noel?
Outseal.
Is in the dictionary, yeah, to sail better or faster than competitor. Ooh. Well done.
Yeah, outsail somebody.
Yeah.
What can we have now in the corner, seven. Barry?
Tailors, seven. And Santor.
Sautoir, sorry. Sautoir. My writing.
Sautoir, yeah. You pronounce it again.
Sautoir, yeah, it's a French word for a long necklace consisting of a fine gold chain set with jewels.
Indeed. Mm. Thank you. 22 to 20, Sarah on 22. Noel's numbers game now.
Could I try four large, please?
You can indeed. Thank you, Noel. Four from the top row and two little ones. And for this challenge, the little ones are 10 and 6. And the big four, 75, 25, 50 and 100. And this target, 345.
345. No.
346.
346 and Sarah?
350.
And 350, so no.
75 plus 10.
75 plus 10, 85.
100 over 25 is 4.
Yep.
Multiply it for 340.
340.
And add to 6.
Yep, 346, one away.
345, Rachel?
Is there, if you say 75 minus 6, is 69, which is the age of our producer whose birthday is today, and then you do 50 over 10, you get 5, and times them together.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Rachel. 345. Well done indeed. So Noel has sprung into the 5-point lead, 27 to Sarah's 22. As we turn to Barry, and Barry, last time you were on the show, you referred to a film that you're involved with, which is now out.
Yeah, it debuted a couple of months ago, absolutely great little movie called Jawbone.
Yeah.
And it's Johnny Harris. It's not an autobiographical story, but it's you know, it centres a lot around his life and his existence. And he won a national title when he was 16, national boxing title when he was 16 years old. And then he sort of went off the rails and became an alcoholic and lost everything. Mm-hmm. And this is a story of redemption, really, him coming back, getting back into the only family that he knows, the family of the community of a boxing club, basically. And it's a great little story, and it features Ray Winston as the coach, and he represents a guy called Mick Kearney who helped the boxing community for probably 30, 40 years. He produced multiple national champions and really helped all the hard-to-reach kids in that area.
Ian McShane plays the manager, and it's a he has one fight in the movie, and it's an unlicensed fight. And Johnny Harris himself is an amazing actor. Paul Weller does the score for the first time he's ever gone into movies, and it's the music is fantastic, and so it's a great sort of compilation of very talented people. And I just done the choreography for the boxing scene. My son Shane and the guys in the gym trained Johnny. He was a national amateur champion, so he was very sort of stand-up boxing. So we had to slow him down and make him move his head a little bit more and introduce a little bit of lateral movement and teach him to fight. And he sparred probably 200 or 300 rounds with good professionals, and he spent a lot of time with us and went through our world title fights and went to them, and he became part of our team, done the circuits every day and really put his heart and soul into it. You know, the fight scenes apparently are one of the best parts of it, so I'm thrilled about that. And I'm great for Johnny because it's a great little story.
And 2 years of hard work.
Yeah, 2 years of hard work. I mean, none of these things come easily. I mean, when I trained Daniel Day-Lewis in 1997 to do the boxer, 2.5 years he spent getting ready for that. But he'd never fought before, and he was just unbelievable. When it was over, Daniel could easily have boxed as a professional fighter. That's how good he was. And Johnny was fantastic. He was an amateur, of course, but absolutely brilliant.
Absolutely. Excellent. All right. Now, Sarah, letters game.
Could I have a consonant, please, Rachel?
Thank you, Sarah. P.
And another.
V.
And a third.
R.
And a vowel.
E.
And another vowel.
A.
And another.
U.
A consonant.
T.
And another.
R.
And a final vowel, please.
And a final E.
Countdown. Sarah?
An 8.
An 8, no.
Just a 6.
And that 6?
Upright.
Sarah?
Aperture.
Well done. A good 8 there. And Susie? Barry?
Rapture 7, aperture 8.
Well done. Aperture 30, plays 27, says back in the lead, and it's Noel's chance now. Letters, Noel.
Could I have a consonant, please?
Thank you, Noel. S.
And another.
F.
And another.
P.
Vowel, please.
I.
And another.
A.
And another.
I.
Consonant.
V.
Vowel.
A.
And a vowel, please.
And lastly, U.
Countdown. Yes, no.
A 4.
A 4, Sarah?
A very risky 5.
No.
Faps.
Faps. Sarah?
Avias. A-V-I-A-S.
A-V-I-A-S. Oh, it's not there. I'm so sorry. It's a really good try, that one.
What did we produce in the corner, I wonder?
Visa.
4. Yeah.
Yeah.
Anything from you?
No, that was our best.
That's it?
4.
Visa. And now, Sarah, it's numbers for you. Sarah.
Could I have 2 large and 4 small, please, Rachel?
You can indeed. Thank you, Sarah. 2 big ones, 4 little ones. And this time, they are 2, 4, 7, another two, and the big ones, 50 and 75. And the target, 809.
809. Yes, Sarah.
I know, I've lost it.
How about Noel?
Just 807.
It'll do.
50 times 2.
100.
Times 2 times 4.
Times the other 2 times 4, 800.
And then add the 7.
Yep, 2 away, 807.
Well done, well done. But 809, Rachel, help us.
It was in there. If you say 75 times 2 is 150, plus the 50 for 200, times that by 4 for 800, and you have a 7 and the spare 2 for 809.
Well done. Well done, Rachel. Spot on, as always, as we turn to our second tea time teaser, which is Tiger Cats. And the clue, planning and preparation are key in this answer. Planning and preparation are key in this answer. Welcome back. I left with a clue. Planning and preparation are key in this answer. And the answer to that one is strategic. Strategic. So 30 plays 38, Noel on 38, and it's Noel's letters game.
Could I have a consonant, please?
Thank you, Noel. N.
And another.
D.
And another.
S.
A vowel, please.
E.
And another.
I.
And another.
E.
A consonant.
L.
And a vowel.
A.
And a consonant, please.
And the last one, W.
Stand by.
A 7.
A 7, Sarah.
Just a 6 this time.
And that 6?
Aliens.
Denials.
And denials.
Very good.
Barry, Susie?
Swindle.
Yeah.
7. Diesel. 6.
Mm-hmm.
What's the other one?
Linseed is also there for 7.
Linseed oil, yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you. 30 plays. Knows 45 now, Sarah. Have a care. Letters game.
A consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Sarah. T.
And another.
S.
And another.
G.
And a vowel.
E.
And another.
I.
And another.
A.
A consonant.
R.
A consonant.
C.
And finish with a vowel, please.
And finish with I.
Stand by. Yes, Sarah.
An 8 not written down.
An 8, no.
Just a 7.
And your 7?
Racist.
Sarah.
Craggiest.
You need 2 G's. Yeah, I'm afraid.
Bad luck. And Barry, Susie.
Well, I'll pronounce it and you can give the definition. Agrestic, which is 8.
Yeah, we'll give you an 8. It means relating to the country, rural or rustic. So it's related to agriculture.
Indeed. Thank you. 52 now. 52 playing 30. Noel having a good a purple patch here as we turn to Susie and her wonderful origins of words. And today, Susie?
Today, Nick, I am going to talk about the story behind All Over Bar the Shouting, which is an expression that means that some situation isn't yet done, but we pretty much know the outcome. But when the end does come, there's often no shouting at all, so it seems a little bit curious on the face of it. But it turns out there did used to be a lot of shouting many centuries ago, because in England, at that time, towns would make major decisions by all gathering together and having a sort of live referendum. And it's called an acclamation. And the louder they shouted on a particular issue, the stronger their voice would be heard. And so it was considered to be a vote. They were incredibly noisy by all accounts. And if before the gathering the outcome of the vote was known or it was obvious, that's when they would say, it's all over bar the shouting. In fact, they were known as shoutings. And there's another similar saying that often puzzles people and which almost means the opposite, and that's, it ain't over till the fat lady sings. And there have been lots and lots of theories about this one. Most of them focus on the American baseball coach Yogi Berra, who was famous for lots of wonderful sayings like, it's deja vu all over again. or my favourite, when you come to a fork in the road, take it. but he did also say, it ain't over till it's over, which sort of makes sense, and that's why people associate it with him. Other people think it goes back to opera and the final aria from Brunhilde in Wagner's Ring Cycle, which is about 14 hours long, so you can imagine some people really were hoping for the fat lady to sing. but in fact, the saying goes right back to the American South in the 19th century, and churchgoers there would say, church ain't over till the choir sings, or similarly, outside of church, they might say, it ain't over till the fat lady sings the blues. It's travelled a long way since those beginnings in the American South, and it's popular today as it ever was.
Thank you, Susie. Now, Noel, penultimate letters game. Off we go.
Could I have a consonant, please?
Thank you, Noel. Y.
And another.
D.
And another.
S.
A vowel, please.
O.
And another.
I.
And another.
O.
Consonant, please.
N.
And a vowel.
E.
And a vowel, please.
And the last one. Another I.
And here's the countdown clock. Yes, no.
A seven.
A seven.
A seven.
And a seven from Sarah. No.
Ionised.
Ionised and?
Iodines.
Susie.
Yeah, ionised, absolutely fine to convert into ions. But iodines, thought long and hard about this one, Sarah, but there's no example with the S on and it does say math noun, so I'm going to have to disallow it, I'm afraid. I'm really sorry.
Oh, bad luck. Yeah. Well, so what can we have, I wonder? Barry, Susie?
Ionised.
Ionised.
As much as we can get.
Thank you. Thank you. 59 to 30 then. And now, Sarah, final letters game. Off we go.
Can I have a consonant, please, Rachel?
Thank you, Sarah. S.
And another, please.
G.
And another.
L.
And a vowel.
O.
And another.
A.
And a third.
E.
And a consonant.
M.
And another consonant.
Z.
And a final consonant, please.
And a final N.
Stand by. Thank you. Yes, Sarah?
Got a risky 8.
No, no.
Just a 7.
That 7?
Mangles.
Mangles and?
On glazes.
On glazes.
On glazes.
Very unlucky again, sir. It's there, but it serves an adjective of a painting or decoration done on a glazed surface, but it's not there as a verb.
In the corner, what offering have we got?
Slogan, 6. Melons, which is 6 again. Lemons and mangles.
Yeah.
That's it?
That's
We're
it.
Done? All right. 66 to Sarah's 30. And it's over to Noel, the maths teacher from Belfast, for the final numbers game.
Could I have 4 large again, please?
You can indeed, thank you. Now 4 from the top. 2 little ones, and the final one of the day is 9 and a 2, and then the 4 large, 50, 25, 75, and 100. And your target to reach 765.
765. No.
766, not written down.
And Sarah?
773.
Right, so we do turn to you, Noel.
I did 75 minus 50.
75 minus 50, 25.
Plus 2.
27.
Multiplied by 25.
Multiplied by 25 for 675.
Plus the 100.
For 775.
And then take away 9.
766, one away.
But still not quite perfect, is it? 765. Rachel, can you help?
Leave it with me momentarily.
Certainly will. So it's 73 to Sarah's 30. A great first outing for Noel as we go into the final round. Fingers on buzzers, please, Sarah. Noel, let's roll today's countdown conundrum. Yes, Noel.
Is it implanted?
Implanted. Let's see whether you're right. Well done. Oh, well done. Well done, Noel. Good score there. 83 points. So I turn to you, Sarah. You had 2 great wins, and then suddenly along comes young Noel McIlvenny. So it's back to Sterling with your goodie bag and a teapot.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for coming.
Thanks for having me. It's been great fun. Thank
Excellent.
You.
Excellent. Have a safe journey home, Noel McIlvenny. You're back with us tomorrow. No rushing back to Belfast. You're here.
Yeah.
All right. Well done. Well done indeed. We shall see you tomorrow. We'll see young Barry McGuigan over there. Lots to talk to you about. And we'll see you tomorrow as well, Susie, of course. But now, Rachel. 765?
Yes, just so Noel doesn't keep me behind after class. If you say 100 times 2 is 200, plus 50 for 250, divide that by 25 for 10, add that to the 75 for 85, and times that by 9.
That's the way. Thank you, Rachel. Well done. No fooling, Rachel, that's for sure. See you tomorrow. Join us then, same time, same place. You be sure of it. You be very sure of it. A very good afternoon to you.
You can contact the programme by email at countdown@channel4.com, by Twitter at C4Countdown, or write to us at Countdown Leeds LS3 1JS. You can also find our webpage at channel4.com/countdown.
Hot on your sums? This will make you feel inadequate in every way. Child genius, the search continues tonight at 8. Next here on Channel 4, Noel is back in his primetime spot. He's ditched the banker. It's all about getting a cheap, cheap, cheap deal.